sugar in one meal, which is heading towards half your daily allowance.
The Butterkiss popcorn, 4 teaspoons. Frosties and all the cereals, I'm not picking on Frosties. And then obviously you're going to add milk to that, which has sugar in too. So you could probably, you're getting close to children, recommended daily allowance for children, Angelica?
24 grams.
Good girl.
See, these are key facts that are, it's really, really important to let your children know these facts, because a classic example, we went to a park in the summer, and we're walking back, it's really hot, and the girl said, can we get a drink, Mummy? So I was like, yeah, of course, we'll go in the sweet shop, got a drink. Do we have to get water? I want something with a taste. I said, okay, you choose. They know that there's 24 grams that they're allowed a day. They know that there's 4 grams in a teaspoon. So when they start to pick up packs, Angelica's saying to me, a Capri Sun has 32 grams of sugar in it. And that's more than an adult's even supposed to have. And these aren't even for adults, they're for children. Mummy, that's disgusting, and she puts it back. I'm not saying a word. All I've done is I've empowered my children with some key facts so they can go along and make the best decisions for themselves. And we did have times, we've been to parties, and they have stuffed themselves on sugar. But because we don't have it at home, they've been laying on the sofa and asking for a hot water bottle by 7 o'clock that evening, because their body's telling them, what are you doing to me? And they're going, Mommy, why have I got a tummy ache? So why do you think? Do you think I have too much sugar? Well, yeah, I do. Mm-hmm. So then what happens is, the next time we go, they'll say, oh no, I've already had a cake thing because I don't want another one. So it's about empowering them and getting them to listen to their body, because that's what we've become so out of check with. We've started to really turn off the messages that our body's sending. And it will send a message on a daily basis. You're thirsty, you're hungry, you're tired, you've got a headache. Why have you got a headache? I had a client that actually said to me, I have to take paracetamol every day because I have the worst headaches. I said, oh, okay, how much water do you drink? I don't drink any water. Okay, so headache's the biggest sign of dehydration, but you want to turn off that sign with a paracetamol. How out of touch are we? How out of touch are we with our own messages and our own body? So that's why I like to let them have them key facts, so they can take that away and use it to their own advantage. And you know what happened that day? Girls, do you remember what we walked out the shop with that day?
No.
Water.
Oh.
We walked out with water in the end, so because they must have put about 6 drinks back. So it's really key, just simple facts to tell children that can then start to make sense of things in their mind, without me saying or doing too much. Okay. 6 teaspoons in a dodgy microwave meal. 5 teaspoons in a can of tomato soup. So that is really recommended daily allowance gone. 9 teaspoons in the sugar in the can of Coke. That's what I said, 35 grams. 4 teaspoons. So yeah, be careful with these drinks, because this one's called vitamin water. So it's trying to lure you into the fact that it's actually a good alternative, full of vitamins, probably just sweetened naturally. Yeah, I'll grab that. But you're looking at quite a lot of sugar there as well. So just start to look on the back of packets, because they really do want to suck you into this. Okay, so let's have a look. Cocoa Pops.